to last stand. Honestly, this is good. Yeah, this is a good way. Okay, we wanna also enable streamer mod because I'm streamer. Yes, I have to remind it to myself because I'm always forgetting. And this is streamer mod, this is now exclusive. Very special. Now I am streamer mod doing streaming. I'm so fucking famous. Guys, you have fucking no idea how much competence you must pack in this big brain to become streamer. I mean, honestly, giant problem was to optimize old PC to transmit this fucking shit in decent quality. No, you cannot fucking stream with that PC, sir. No, it's terrible. How do you fucking pack 16 gigabytes memory in this 8 gigabytes of RAM DDR3? This is fucking impossible. Impossible is fucking nothing with my optimization. Guys, you underestimate the power of my mods, honestly. Look at this. I have only 1% packet lost. This is fucking naughty. This means I will ensure you that quality will be good. The fuck? Wait a fucking moment. Holy shit, look at this display. Just basic optimization. Nothing to see, this was always metal texture or glass metal. Holy fucking shit, I love this. Okay, wait a moment. I was catching Raticate. I mean, I don't play Pokemon because it's a game for children. Let me catch local. I mean, I catch capturing male Pokemon versus male Pokemon with local. It works. It works every time. Like, imagine needing to have plants. By capturing Raticate, I don't have to evolve Rattata to have... One moment, please. Dude, this game has lore. Never mind. I will save this garbage and will focus full on Kenshi. I'm sorry for this. Easy. Yeah, how actually game works? I wonder if actually capturing OBS will keep me going. Okay. We are near Great Fortress. This place were ruined, but once you beat Kralchuzan, it's living again. And we will go there because I'm curious to check. There are some boring people. Okay, now my goal. It's working. How I'm doing? Let me like crunch these numbers. My current goal is to some basic crossbow training, maybe. Quality is set to auto. We'll set it to source for good measure. I hate auto because it's automatically trained to readjust itself. Let's quick save. Let me check temperatures just really quick. Yeah, that was quick save lag. Honestly, game works like a rocket. I mean, as I promised in my fucking optimization. But I'm streaming right now, so I did not expect myself to be able to stream and run it in 60 frames. I stream in 30 frames because fuck you, I deserve quality, you deserve nothing. But I mean, if I would play in 30 frames, I could not stream 60 frames, because that would be idiotic, okay? You have to understand this. I don't know how to make Twitch being able to like select quality. Because right now I have only source or auto. But some streamers have like 72 and 720, 480, something like this. That would be perfect for me. Because honestly, my internet is not as good to watch my own stream just in case in source quality. It is generally a bad thing. I would rather fucking play Trianni maybe. I'm not sure, I mean this game is so fucking slow. Like guys, I literally did my best to make this game faster, better and stuff. But it's fucking not. Kraus chosen fate cover. Does this change name or something? Look at the quality of this image. This is my fucking godly optimization. Honestly, I had no idea these things will stay here. You can use them to train, and this is level 15. I mean, it's garbage because to beat Krauchuzen you already need to be above that. One. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, good. I wanted to make sure everyone is together without checking map. I can honestly say Kenshi is a fun game. Just slow. I also wanna test my improved spider AI, however, these improvements might be very vague because I did not do much to them. Yeah, current setup I find very speedy. It's good. I mean, it's probably less heavy than before in case of streaming versus gaming. And let me just check OBS to make sure. Yes, I still have 1% of missing frames. A new case of line. Fuck. Maybe I should DM him. I mean, I'm pretty proud of this setup, it's worse than before, but it's also better because it's worse. I mean, I exchanged some of the image quality you were unable to see because I were unable to upload it correctly into the consistent streaming quality which you were able to see and experience. We are at day 8827. Honestly, by telling number of days, I might practice my English, so why not? I mean, I find myself being more annoying than funny sometimes, but I manage. I mean, this visual quality of this game is serving me well, so I don't have to be very eloquent in my conversation. Okay, let's make a fucking screenshot. I mean, just sheer fact that I can stream it and not dying this view is like a lot. Before, I had extremely fucking laggy experience for people who watch me. Now, I still have rather bad experience for people who watch me. But it's better bad experience than it was. I mean, image might be less sharp, I'm not sure. I mean, it's decent. In this screenshot, I see my own screen, okay? And from what I see, it's decent. I was making screenshot there, so it's small delay. Yeah, image is almost as fast as I see in game, slightly slower and slightly more like choppy. But honestly, now you can at least fucking follow what is happening in my screen, so I see it as giant improvement. I optimized everything for streaming, because even if I'm not very good at streaming, I consider it to be like way to go, because I can like optimize to make videos better. But honestly, I don't find myself being very good video producer. Even if I sometimes like point out things to say and follow them, I usually take several takes to make sure everything lands perfectly. I have no idea what is this this bar saying. I never saw it before. I rarely experience this bug. Loading, but I'm not loading anything. Like, come on, guys. What I would be loading? I'm just traveling. I'm just kidding, obviously, but okay, I feel like I don't play in 60 FPS right now. I don't feel 60 FPS game. This is huge. Some people would say that playing on ultra high with shadows is rather poor idea for seeing FPS. But these people know nothing about my optimization. Am I hearing my fans right now? This is new. Oh yes, I remember when I cried in this red mist when it appeared. What does people want? I remember when this red mist. Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Okay. You might fucking wonder. What the fuck? You see, when I alt tab. Game. Switch my squads. So you can at least experience out of nowhere alt tab loading time. And this weird button glitch appear again. I'm not sure why game have this button, like, honestly I can see everything. Just because you load what? Shades on tree? Come on, shader saw should work fast. Look at this beautiful fucking foliage. Imagine playing on less foliages. Pathetic. Okay, I honestly was feeling that. I feel this green bar loading. Okay. It's mostly when you do something like fast zone hopping. I'm not entirely sure why I'm in spider planes and don't see any spiders. But not my problem. I told them to go to last stand and we might wanna go to like workshop complex maybe. Maybe Berserk Village. As far as I know, player should not be like hostile with Berserkers from the start, I'm not sure. Because I know Berserkers are bandits. I just wonder if player is hostile with them from the start or not. I assume not, but I am clearly hostile with them. Look at fucking this. Imagine having a fucking FPS troubles because you load some of the fucking red mists. Imagine having slight FPS delay. Small frame drop over this. I cannot. Truly disgusting. Fucking console peasants. Guys, just get my optimization, really. Nobody should ever fucking suffer from low FPS's on this garbage shit trash game. Honestly. I mean, I like Kenshi, okay? I played for ages, I just... Honestly, there is like so much developer could have done to make it better. I mean, if I could have like source code and would be able to compile and update this game, I would not achieve much alone because I'm not very competent at this level of programming. However, I know a lot of people who would be willing to help me. Maybe custom launcher is actually way to go for Kenshi. But what could custom launcher for Kenshi achieve? I don't know. Yeah, this is like most boring part of Kenshi, when you like don't know where you go, but you know it's gonna be fucking boring, because this game is empty as fuck. Okay, we like training stealth, so we wanna go for my most stealthy characters. These two. And I feel like I gained something over this eternity. We are going to the crater. Because apparently spider planes don't have any spiders. Especially if you killed Bugmaster. And don't wanna explore deeply, just around. Reason why I don't explore deeply, because honestly, it's spider planes. I don't have my portable crossbow kits with me, because I left them at home, probably, or in one of the backpacks, but not this one, of course. I don't fucking know why, I mean, it's just hard, okay? The problem is, you cannot open Garu backpack inside the chest. Oh, okay, that was my internet lag. That was my another internet lag. And that was another internet lag. I wonder if just me on source. And I'm unable to watch my own fucking stream. Or I'm unable to upload my own fucking stream, because in second... thing. No, I'm uploading normally, okay. Sorry for panicking, it's just, you know, since you cannot set quality to designated 7020 and you use source 7020, it's much worse. However, yeah, this optimization towards OBS and towards Kenshi itself were extremely useful for me, because I can fucking finally stream that garbage. Holy shit, that was taking me so long to get right. You have no freaking idea. Let me see packet lost. 06. This is my frame loads lost when I'm streaming for you. Can you fucking imagine? Can you even comprehend that improvement on quality? Fuck, where is Nukla when I need his adoration and admiration towards my fucking... you have no idea how long I tried to do it right, I mean... Honestly. Like chat, only long time viewers would understand. The struggle I'm dealing with, and Holy fucking shit, we need to stop me from alt-tabbing. Because I'm done with spamming how fast I can load in a new zone. I mean, I don't wanna embarrass your junky 2 years old PCs with my 11 years old office laptop, like, come on guys. I mean, I understand not everyone can afford this. This $300 piece of junk. Console piece on disgusting, like, honestly. Like, I fucking care. Okay, because I have loading, now we are inventing colors, and this mist was loading like gray, green before. By the way, imagine having fucking fast zone hopping on when you fast zone hop in 1 second without in all. Wait, I should once do you like little tests. Of course, out of memory errors are no more as well. My temperatures are under control, however GPU is at 60 something. Honestly, we run speedfan just to make sure. I mean, I'm nearly sure it's not more than 64. But 64 would be already like catastrophic. Okay, good. I was kind of worried for a moment. Speedfan refused to load. I am worried that I don't have memory at all, and my PC is just pretending that everything is fine. But I severely out of processing power to compute everything. Yeah, I'm out of memory, like, for sure. There is like giant spike of usage. Lost frames dropped again to 0.5. Where my FPS on video dropped to 27 instead of 30. Okay, I'm 61. But CPU is 51. Okay, 55 CPU. It should drop to... Maybe we'll stay. I mean, honestly, it's pretty heavy area. I just wanna make sure that, you know... I like quality, okay? I like quality of image and stuff. But this is old PC, and I need to take care of it. So, you know, besides... growing, like, idiotically... stupidly a large amount of everything, I still do care about my performance. It's not like I'm being idiotic about it. Give me a moment. I wonder what the fuck. Yes, this is the place. Yes. Honestly, this loading is killing me. But it's good. I like honestly having fun in there. It's just like. Honestly. Okay, now we're gonna do a little bit of photographic magic. So please don't be too scared. It will be. Okay, I might wanna like not show you something because I clearly not use heretical mods and totally not of my own production. That will be disgusting. Female body is disgusting, remember that. Twitch ban for female body. Especially female nipples. Can you fucking imagine? Tfu. Imagine having titties. Gorgeous love spawn. No, no. We cannot have that on Twitch TV. This is a serious platform. There were never any Twitch tots. Never. That would be fucking illegal. I feel fucking short. Woman. You're making me feel short. That's terrible. That's unacceptable in Okran. I had no idea I made her so fucking large compared to my poor guy. I mean, I'm usually not that smart, okay? Wait a moment. We want dust kick to. Let's save and let's go forward. Oh wait, I have only grid shot. I don't have without map shot. That's terrible. Okay, let's go forward. I don't know why I have this loading on screen. It should be not loading, it should be playing. We are playing here, loading is not gaming. But I'm glad to be here. I wonder if I should go deep into this workshop complex and... I promised crater, right? Yes, I promised craters, so we might wanna go there. Which is terrible, because that's mean I will have to reset navmesh, because I'm nearly sure this location loads badly. Badly! I wish badly. 68 is not badly, it's terrible. I'm almost fucking sure. Yeah, they were going wrong way all this time. Anyway, let's go forward. According to my own knowledge, they will either go to this red road or go through the grid. I'm not sure, I rarely investigate this passage, honestly, like nobody really go from swamp labs or swamp village to ruins inside of crater. And if they go, they go to lab ruins, so this is easy because it's double road. I mean, you go there, you jump from there to there, from there to there, and from there to there. And from there, there. And you are in. Famous dancing skeleton. No, fuck it. We're not going to swamps. Like, honestly... I don't wanna, like, witness another civil war. Okay, that's for sure. Another issue with going to swamps. It's also massive attacks of spiders that just randomly go after my stolen goods. And stolen goods is my animal. I mean, he can handle himself in combat, okay? It's nothing like danger to him, it's just annoying to have like wands or have him in fights or have him to be inside because everyone else is inside. This is pool. No. This is water? I mean, they will avoid it as water, that's for fucking sure. And I don't see water reflection or any particles. But there, that might be water. I saw something that resembles water particle. We need better qualities. I don't know, maybe I could like ask Twitch staff if they could like unlock me 720p, not source. But I'm not sure. I might also wanna improve my panels, because they are at right now my panels are kind of outdated and garbage. I mean, they are still true to some degree. It's just... I just feel like I could put more work into them, maybe. It's not that bad. The stream update logs, cool. For example, I'm not sure if that's interest anybody, not even me. I stopped doing that for sure. Like you see, when I started, I tried to like maintain like progression whenever I was, you know, I tried to like make something, to not waste time, to not just be streaming uselessly. But it's not like I achieved a lot. It's minor improvements there and there, either microphone or streaming quality. But it's never like, you know, like I can do a lot. I cannot improve my connection more than I did already. I found few tricks that can I basically like make my Wi-Fi card function better and make sure it's ensure most useful connection for me at given moment. Honestly, we are too fucking close to not go there. There is absolutely no fucking way to not go there. That would be criminal waste. So when you are in locations like this, most important stuff is to even fucking load them correctly and see. If it's explorable or not, because it's empty. I mean, I can go there, okay, but it's empty. This workshop complex is empty. It's okay, not every dungeon must have a loot. It's not like I'm main protagonist looking for items. No, completely not. I mean, I'm not looking for items. I just wanted to explore. What do we have here? Okay, I need to pause to make my brain process whatever is happening on screen. Okay, this is first workshop and this is second workshop. Okay, I'm good. I just wanted to make sure they did not some weird pathfinding shenanigans that I will need to fucking cure in my mod and will spend like eternity crunching to improve. Because that will be extreme. Because you see, for you it might look like normal fucking stream, but for me, whenever I experience bug with my fucking mod, I cannot stand it. I mean, quality control is strong, okay? Like, quality control is out of this world. Imagine these never happy people who always complain about everything. Imagine if they will be judging your every single mod you ever do. Yeah, quality control is strong. No, I'm not sure. Ruins. Nice. Never mind. Let's just go there and that's it. We can also nav mesh fix. Oh, I have stable nav mesh. That's new. Here you have iron resource. I'm not sure why Ruka took that path. It's less optimal, honestly. I mean, she will be ahead, okay. But this dynamic direction change wasn't needed there. This shadow flickering is pissing me off. This object is fully loaded. And I'm not sure if that shaders are or basic Kenshi shadow casting methods. I'm sorry about this loading, I'm not sure what is happening. I did not intend my game to display these weird bugs. Do this way. Game is definitely worth its price and it's very good to play, especially if you have like 2 hours at evening and just wanna have fun. However, it's fair to say that the game is impossible to run smoothly without some trickery. Even if you have like the nervest PC in the world, you will crash every fucking second, he told me. This is given. Basically, game needs a lot of treatment. Oh, holy shit, wait a fucking moment, what are you guys doing? Oh, fuckers! Hello. Oh. Okay. I did not intend to be chased by these sheets. But I can sneak fast. Goal would be first, second, third. If I could get there, I should be invisible. Okay, change of plans. Well, hello there. I don't see anything. I highlight with tab. With alt. I'm sorry. And I don't see anything. There is no loose item on the ground. That's new. Okay, we go there. We straight go to top floor. And we will be looting from there. There is absolutely no freaking reason to not sneak loot it. It's like most safety and appropriate way to do this shit right now. Ruka, please! Ruka, you fucking bitch! Ruka, you loot! Why are you so fucking dumb? Stop! Don't ruin my fucking operation, please. Okay, okay, my plan works. You see, that was just part of my genius. Look at this shit. Everything was fucking planned from the start. This feels like brand new games in brand new quality right now. I'm so fucking glad V10 was so good. Like all changes, I made like 3 versions of V10 and I wasn't sure which one will be best. Until like I finished my testings. If you see saw it, I almost like. Yeah, as you can see, they are neutral to me. Look at this damage, by the way. They are like obliterating big things on the spot. I admit I underestimate them. For me, they are like worthless piece of shit that people just cry about because they are weak. Okay, we want this. We want this. We want this. Honestly, take that too. Already known research I don't need, but I will take science book any day. And this is hard to produce, so I will take it. Boring. Oh no. Oh, for fuck's sake, I will have to loot this. This will take me hours. Look at this. Every single one of these boxes can be fucking looted. Okay, lucky it's just junk for now. I have honest respect to any medical equipment. Most people who would work at public healthcare in Europe would, I assume. Maybe not in every sector of Europe. This is bad. Badly loaded. I had to F11. It's okay. It's not okay. It's holy shit, it's so bad. Okay, it's good. Home territory aggression, and this is very bad. Come on. That's just a prank, bro. Holy shit. Okay. Okay, this is damage control. You normally don't wanna do this. How the fuck do you even dare to fucking exist? This shit is so fucking strong. Die, fucker. Look at this. I decapitated three legs of this shit, and this is still existing. Your existence insult me. Die. That will do you kindly. Yeah, whatever, Scar. Sorry, you can completely obliterate them with the broken martial arts. Yeah. Yeah, forgot. Forgot about it. It was good. Honestly, I don't know, like, if I would like to, like, hunt the spiders, I could do that. It's not giant effort. Okay, this is good to have. I've been taking this one, so I can take one more. Same. And just check this. Already know. I just wanna make sure. Same. Same, same. And let's pick the lock. Three of my characters are able to lock with this. Oh, that was fucking fast. Holy shit, this is treasure. Stolen goods, will you kindly... And this one. Okay, that was fun. Fuck iron plates and let's go. Let me just quick save. What does stone goods hold? It does not hold electric parts yet. I hate this. They are right next to fucking each other. Out of fucking trading range. My ass. This bug is only in structures. We are not that far, game, come on. Honestly, we can give him some rough meat. Okay, like this. Minimal inventory management, just, you know, since I'm here. Save, because you don't wanna potentially repeat inventory management. Let's go towards lab ruins. Mostly to find big king nests and sneak around them so I can get sneak XP. Okay, that is cute. I must say, Kenshi is like a lot of fun, even if I'm just like relatively passive right now. I still have decent time. It's not super fun for me because I were playing it for ages. It's just, you know, I feel like I'm exploring completely new. This is basically Kenshi 2 for me. Stolen goods. Stolen goods. Stolen goods. Why is your move order so fucking not moving? Okay. This is stuck. Okay, he's like, wait. Okay, this is not stuck. Okay. As for this sneaking problems, I would not complain that much. A lot of people likes complaining about stuffs. It's just sneak experience faster. Oh, that was new. Yeah, Izumi is much faster once she got hit. Because once characters get hit. Their run settings also change. From run together to run as up. Ruins, they are in front of me. And they have like nothing of value. Good. Yeah, Seto is instant target. Possibly for her notorious reputation of killing victims. Possibly. Like. Izumi is obviously ahead because this early hit. But she's not much ahead, we will catch up to her. And dynamic direction change works even if single person is burst ahead. It's just not... It's not very efficient, I just, you know, make few meters each corner. It's not like a super innovative technology, it's just some improvement over vanilla patching. Okay, this is new. And fast. Let's go to clone study. Three XP. Let's quick save. River Raptors, this is your biggest ally versus big things. River Raptors and Big Ticks has things against each other. I don't know how it works. And they are too dense. Without it, they will get hit. Sadly, Darkbite is too fucking fast. By the way, if you wonder why I'm not just fighting them, it's mostly because I wanna train sneak speed. And whenever a character has this red eye, it means he's playing very dangerous game, so they gain a lot of XP. And since athletics and sneaking are extremely hard to max, I just focus on it. By the way, the reason why these big things are chasing me for so long and not getting stuck on everything is because I'm testing my better AI for NPCs. And let's just say it's improved patching of every single fucking creature you can use. Big Things has still Vanilla Strength and Vanilla Speed. They just use their own speed better. The mod is not published yet because I only made few useful qualities. I don't wanna publish half-baked product, even if that's, you know, free mod. Oh, hello, Slaver. Good to see you. Honestly, if I would like check better, I would use them to fight big things instead of fighting them myself. But it's okay, like, not much difference. We'll save in clone steady and probably end stream on this, you know, smalt run, testing streams. It's just worth noticing that your improvements in quality are real. I mean, I feel loading and loading bar game. Game, why do I see this weird loading bar? Boring. I feel disengaged from game because I'm loading map. And sadly, I cannot blame my optimization. It's really best build I could made. I mean, maybe I will find some improvement. Like, I'm not sure when. I mean, I'm not even willing to test anything new for now. Like, it works. It's best setup so far. And I don't wanna. I feel like I made V10 right after V9 just because I find few improvements. Like, improvements from V8 to V9 are giants, improvements from V9 to V10 are big and substantial, and I don't regret making up new version. Just, you know, less giant. Okay. Not okay. Not okay. Not okay. This is completely not okay. I'm not sure what is happening. This is my CPU problem or something? Wait a moment. Yeah, there is some warning in my OBS. But missing frames are. Maybe internet had just like problems. I'm not sure. Anyway, we made it to clone steady. And they will most likely cross this river. However, I'm not sure. Because I don't know how well a map loaded from far distance. As you saw, I had loading bar. Okay, good enough. Technically, my patching fix should probably capture this bridge, but it's extremely fast road to cross this river, so I don't complain. Just, you know, for you to picture the difference. Not giant deal, we made it, and that would be it. I have like no clue what I will be doing in next stream because I had no interest in being in clone steady in the first place. But it was cool. Also, let me check if my sneaking did not improve by another percent. No, sadly not. Okay, thank you all for watching and see you next time I will be streaming. I usually stream Tyranny or Kenshi because for now these are my two favorite games. I have other games to play, it's just, you know, these two are the best.